Hello and welcome along. Today we are getting started on the West Coast. We have our John Deere 2058 here, and we're going to start with the harvest. We're going to start harvesting this canola here, and hopefully punch this field out today. On carting duties, we have our TW15, so that should be more than enough for what we need. And I think really we'll just get to it. So without further ado, let's jump in the combine. Unfolder. There we go. Starter up. Oh. There we go. And away we go. Turn around. So, obviously, as this is canola, as this is OSR, there will be no straw coming off it. We will need to do a harvest that will produce some straw at some point. But this is just a great way to kick us off. A nice simple harvest that allows us to take in the sides a little bit. Right, I'm going to reverse up a bit. This is a very sharp corner on the first corner. And away we go. Yeah, there we go, that's got it. So the fields on the map are fairly decently sized. This is probably one of our bigger fields to start. So we will see how far we get on it, because this is a very big field and not a very big combine. But we'll see how we go. We won't be stopping too much, because obviously this is OSR and that yields less than our than the wheat and the barley does. But it does sell quite well, so you know, there is that trade-off. But it does mean we'll be emptying less. Really is where I'm rambling towards. Now this is the field I've seen. So this. What we're going to do is we're going to do the main body of this field then, I think, to begin with, seeing as this is the field with the footpath through the middle of it. Yeah. So I'm very careful not to lose that, not to get rid of that footpath. I'm hoping the way the field is defined, it won't matter. But yeah, I do like the fact that the footpath goes through the middle of this field. That's pretty cool. Something similar was done. I did something similar on Culper Park Farm, but it was never this well defined. So very nice. Very, very nice. Sometimes it takes a while to maneuver around these corners, especially when they're as sharp as this. This is a very interesting field. So I love it hard. That is just gorgeous. The sunset over the lighthouse. That's just beautiful. Down that valley. Loving that. That is absolutely incredible. I'm gonna pop into the cab for a little while, I think. See how long it's going to take us to do one round of the field. I think, from the looks of it, it's just over about Well, maybe about 5 minutes or so. So, yeah, we'll see how we do. Maybe a case of that we have to go dual combines with this. 25% full off our first round of the field. I think we will probably be splitting this field from the looks of it. And from the looks of how long it's taken us to go around the first thing, I think we will be splitting this harvest over 2 episodes. So we will probably get the headland done this time, and then we'll look to get the main body of the field done next time. There we go. Which we've done quite we've done a few times before, so, but I think looking at the way it's going, that's probably the way we're going to do it. So I think if there's anything else we need to do around the farm to kick us off, and at the moment there isn't really. Everything is kind of ready to harvest, and that's kind of what we've got to do to start off with. It does mean we'll have a field to plow and cultivate, and I think, yeah, we'll be able to crack on with this field from that point of view very quickly. This is, I'm liking the inside of the cab of this combine. It's a nice place to be. Finding the textures on it a little bit flat, but I think a little bit of tweaking wouldn't fix. Around the corner. So I think we're going to do 4 headlands. That's what we'll do here. Once we've done the headlands on this field, we will probably go and do the headlands on the main part of the field. We'll probably go and do the headlands, maybe on the small bit. And get that out as well. And maybe we might even be able to get the whole of that small bit out today, which would be absolutely brilliant. I think what we will find with this is probably getting some animals started. So we're gonna need to do. Now we've got 2 choices. We're actually really well set up for the cows off the get-go, except of course we don't have anything in the way of silage or straw bales or anything like that, whereas if we get sheep, apart from the sheep being cheaper, you can also get them going a bit quicker with some grass, because all they need is the grass, and water. So we might kick off with the sheep and just grab some of the bits for that. I'm trying to think if I've put, I don't think I've put any grass, I don't think I've put pretty much anything down at the sheep. I do know, I put a set of forks for the forklift down with the sheep. So there is that. Yeah. I think we may start getting some animals in fairly swiftly after this harvest. This harvest should afford us some money to go and get some. We'll go and see if we can sell this. Once we've done that, the other one we probably do have enough to get started with the exception of the straw, is the pigs. But my thing with the pigs is we won't see any return from them for a while, and I want to get something going animal wise that's going to give us a good return fairly quickly, so that we can then reinvest it into the animals. And the sheep will do that in that their wool actually pays really well. But the best ones really would be the cows, if we could get them up and running fairly quickly. So we'll see how we go. We'll see how much money we make off this field, I think. But I think that there is a wheat or a barley harvest in our future, because we are going to need straw. And we are going to need to make some silage, which we can buy bales in if we need to, but it's a really expensive way of doing it, and if I'm looking to get things up and running fairly quickly, that's not a great way to start. Yeah, field 15 I need to look at, really. Field 5 looks ready, and field 7 has a lot of grass in it, but we don't own either of them. Which ones do we own? 15, 10 and 14 around here. 30 up at the cows. Down at the sheep. We don't own anything down at the sheep. I thought we did. Yeah, I thought we owned something down that way. Oh yes, we do. We own 81, which looks like a grass field. So we do own two grass fields, 30 and 81. So both of those would be useful for this. Gonna need the other thing we don't have that we're gonna need is probably something to turn corn into chaff. Probably need to look to plant some corn for that. There we go. Right. Yeah. Really? So we've got one more headland to do, I think. After this. And that, I guess. Yeah, so I need I'm sort of planning out what I'm going to do on the next few episodes. Want to try and differentiate myself from Upton a bit, which getting into the animals really early in here when we haven't on Upton, I think, is a good plan to go with. So that's what we're going to do. We are 75% full, so we're not going to make it the whole way around the field again. So I think we will try and get unloaded with the T-Dub along the far side. So as we're starting our fourth headland. Well, actually, to be honest, we've probably cut into the main body of the field. So I'm going to put this out. Well, I said I was going to sort of do headlands this time and main body of the field next. We're actually in a good position to do the main body of the field without the extra bit now. So I'm just going to jump out, grab the T-Dub. We need to do this before we cut into the field. Go. These Marston trailers perfect for this map, of course. Being bullet bills trailers as well. There we go. Nice, fast unloading on this combine. Right, we'll park the tractor here. So it's nicely out of the way. And then we'll head back to the combine. Target ourselves down the field. There we go. Not that close to either end. I think we've basically gone right down the middle. I don't know if multi-terrain is on this map. That will be interesting to find out. Very cool if it was. Right. So that is our first cut through. We have opened up the field, which is great. If I discover that I'm getting an area that's too big, then what I'll do is I'll cut in again. There we go. But for now, I'm just basically going to treat these as two separate fields. There we are. There we go. So really, actually, I'm going to throw out to you guys, which set of animals would you like to see me start with? Should we start with the cows or should we start with the sheep? I'm in two minds about either of them. The cows we can get going, just not at full strength. The sheep we could get going with full strength, but obviously aren't going to give us any immediate return. So yeah, which would you like to see me get started with on here? Let me know in the comments, should we have a look at the cows or should we have a look at the sheep? I think on that, I'm going to start throwing out, I think, a lot more stuff to you guys and going, what would you like to see me do? Would you like to see me do this or that? Let me know in the comments, because I think interaction on these is important, and it's a great way to give you guys a bit of ownership on these videos. So yeah, Watch out for that. Most episodes, I will try and ask a question. What would you like to see A or would you like to see B? In the comments, and we'll go from there. We will move forward with that. See how that works. See what kind of response we get. But yeah, certainly, I would like you guys to be a little more involved in what we do on these. Oh, I turned the tractor off, so I don't know how full my trailer is. I know my trailer holds at least 2 full tanks. And I know from previous experience, if you don't empty out a full tank, so we emptied at sort of 75 to 80%, then you can get 3 in. Which is why I have the rule of a trailer. Any trailer that I have on a map needs to hold twice the volume of the combine. There we go. So I think this main part of the field, without the bit beyond the footpath, we should get that out and get that done this episode. I see no reason why we won't. We're a good 3/4 through the field at this point. Fantastic. I didn't expect to be this far. And it's working really well. We are at 25%. That's perfect. But I think we're probably going to get a couple of loads off the combine here as well. So when we have a full yield, we will do nicely off this field. We'll probably get it goes up to about 1.5 times, so we'll probably get two trailer loads, I would expect. Maybe not both full trailer loads, but yeah, certainly 2 trailer loads off. And if you take into consideration the bit beyond the footpath, then even more, I think. Field 11 is a nice big field as well. I do love the footpaths that Bill's put into this. It's nice, and it's very realistic. It's very reminiscent of the English countryside. This invokes the English countryside to me a lot. Love the view down that valley to the lighthouse. That is just amazing. I wanted to. Don't be surprised if there's a screenshot looking down that valley with this combine, because that is just. I'm loving the look of that look down there. Just sort of opens up and frames that lighthouse so beautifully. And especially when we're doing this at sunset. It just makes all the difference. Right, so I think, I'm not sure, we may do. So looking at what I'm going to do next time, we won't do the end bits of the field on camera, because honestly I'm not going to do another full harvesting episode. But we do need to do something. Oh, I know what we can do. Whether we do sheep or the cows, based on your feedback. What we will do next time is probably get started on mowing some grass, because we do need Whether we go with the cows or whether we go with the sheep, we are going to need some hay. So I think we'll see if we can start creating some hay bales next time. Because we are going to need hay bales, certainly. Whether we go, cows or sheep. We can feed the sheep hay bales, so I think it's a good start for that. And we'll get a trailer full of grass as well. And we can actually put food in the feed troughs ready for them. So that will work well, I think. Right, I think we'll finish off this side of the field. Now. So this is the advantage. Once you get to a certain point, of course, you can then start just... You don't need to cut through, you can cut down either side. Finishes that strip off. It works as a very nice divider and keeps your auger on the outside. Let's do this. There is our 50%. Now looking at this being an N-reg, I'm fairly sure N-reg would have been mid 90s, wouldn't it? Just thinking, I had a Golf from about 92 that I think was a J-reg. So this is a mid 90s combine. So it wouldn't have been, yeah, at the time on my dad's farm, we would have been driving New Holland. So my uncle's farm might still have had John Deere's. Look on mine. And they do, the rumours of what John Deere's, especially combines, tend to do with the flying on fire is very true. I have actually seen one burnt out, so we'll have to keep an eye on this one. It's actually, I was worried it wasn't going to be a big enough combine to do what I wanted to do. And it's not bad actually. It's not bad at all. So we are, we've not got a huge amount left to do. So slightly longer episode this time. So this combine is working well on here. It's a good size for it. Try to work out, is field 10 one of our larger fields? Actually field 10 is not bad as far as field size goes. There's no huge fields on this map. So yeah, if this combine can handle this field fairly well, you shouldn't have any issues most of the time, I don't think. Down. So then we have just got that patch over there to finish up. We are at 65%. So this being canola, I reckon we're going to finish on about 90-95%. And certainly we will have enough to fill the tractor. Well, to fill the trailer. I don't think it won't be more than one full load of the trailer, thankfully. That's not a bad judgment for width. I mean, that just means that we have a good width left to pick up that easily fits in the header. So, yeah. I hate the widths that just fit. That always causes me issues. But this I can fairly easily make sure that I pick all of it up, and I'm not going to leave any. But it's not like a single row of canola to pick up. It's yeah, it's working absolutely fine, and we are at 72% full. Right. Go. Yeah. Round into the last section. We're about 4 or 5 cuts, I think, on this, and the thing about it as well is that it is a lot smaller than that other end. So we can knock this whole thing out. 75% full. Which of course means that everything is now flushing. Interesting, this doesn't have a rear beacon on it, this combine. So the front beacon is going off. But but there is no rear beacon. Right. Okay. Of course, it's a little bit of a funny shape down the side. So we need to straighten that out. Although that is one of the reasons why you cut into the field, so that you keep everything, you know, fairly straight from the get-go. We may have to empty. It's gonna be closer than I expected. Although we are cutting sort of a triangle shape at the moment. I went with sort of the longest side of the field rather than the grain of how this had been sown, because it would have been a much shorter, much more fiddly way to do it the other way. But yeah, normally I try to go with how the field has been sown, otherwise, well, in real life it would get really bumpy otherwise. So that is basically the longest side of this gone. just a little bit more to do. Alright, we've got two more cats, I think. Finish this off. It's not that much of a triangle. It looked more extreme than I think it is when we were coming back the other way. Right, and down. Yeah, it is still a triangle. We are still going to end up with a wedge at the end. But it means that the wedge is getting a lot smaller with every cut we do. How full are we? We are at 93%. Ah. That's both good and bad. Is there 7% of the... What would be jarring? What would be an issue would be if... it was something like 102%. Don't think it's going to be. I think it is just going to fit inside our grain tank, but yeah, does worry me slightly. Right, there we go. I think what I'm going to have to do is treat either side of this footpath almost as a There's two separate fields, and what we can do is we either plant the same thing in the upper half of the field, as has been done at the moment, or we can put a small crop of something that we only need a small amount of in up there. Right, and last little bit, we are at 98%, absolutely perfect. It was worth keeping going. Right, and over to here. And empty in. There we go. We're over the side a bit. There we go. And that's a pretty good place to end it. So all that remains, really, is for me to say thank you for watching. I hope you have enjoyed this episode. Please give it a like, drop us a comment, and give it a share. And for all the latest videos and live streams from Virtual Farmer, please subscribe to the channel. I will see you next time. Goodbye.